Guten Tag, Ibra Army, and welcome back to another IBRACORP video. Thanks for tuning in this week. It's a pleasure to have you back. We're going to be trying something different over the next few videos. We're going to be trying to say hello in a couple of different languages. So that's going to be my thing now. So hopefully I say them correctly. I'll do my best, but if I don't, someone correct me in the comments and I'll make sure I'll fix it up the next time I try it. Today, we're going to be looking at Requestrr. For those coming to check out what it is, Requestrr is a chatbot used to simplify using services like Sonarr, Radarr, Overseerr, Ombi via the use of chat. If you run your own Discord server, this is going to be the solution for you. And it's really going to help you and your users of Plex or any other media server that you use to really enjoy making requesting easy. It integrates, like I said, with Overseerr and Ombi, as well as the PVRs Sonarr and Radarr. So it allows us to have a seamless way to request content across different channels. So if you want to know more how to install it, get it running, and see how it looks, then stick around. We hope you'll enjoy the video. With that said, let's get into it. All right, guys, so welcome back this week. It's a pleasure to have you back. We're looking at probably one more video before the end of the year where we head into Christmas time, and obviously we all need a well-needed break, I can assure you that. But you're coming in today to see what we've got installed. It's going to be hopefully a pretty cruisy one. We're looking at Requestrr. Now, I've been using Requestrr for at least a year, I think, however long this has been up. I've pretty much been using it from the start, and I've never looked back. And the form that it's in now is honestly even better than when it started by a long shot. So I highly recommend you guys come and check it out. It's really, really cool. So here we are on the GitHub for Requestrr and the developer DarkleFX at Requestrr. Okay, so as we do in every video, guys, if we show off an app that you really enjoy, come over to their official page, whether it's their website or GitHub or whatever, and maybe give it a star. Give them some feedback, and if they have an option to donate to their work. These guys are working in and out to bring out some awesome apps. So please help support your local developer. So here we are on Requestrr, and it's got a few features. We've mentioned a couple of them already. It's got Apple's Siri integration, pretty cool. Users can get notified when their request's complete. So it has a really good messaging system, letting you know directly via DMs or in a public chat when a request has been fulfilled. It has Overseerr integration with support for per user permissions / quotas. Now that's an important one. So we can actually set permissions based on what we have in Overseerr. So if you have a quote for people to only be able to request 5 movies a week or whatever the case might be, then we can integrate that into Requestrr, which is cool. It's got Ombi V3 integration with support for per user roles and quotas as well. And it's fully configurable via a web portal. So there's a couple of steps here on how to install it. If you're running an operating system that is not Unraid and you just have, you know, a typical Docker environment on whatever OS, in this case, then here's your Docker command so that you can run it via Docker run. Or if you want to convert it to a compose file, however you choose to do that, there's the command for you ready to go. So just copy and edit it as required. So your path, obviously, where you want it to save on the host, and then run that and you should be away and running. And then you'll be able to access it at this address. For those on Unraid, however, we're going to head over to the App Store and we'll look for Requestrr. As usual, we get a couple of different options from a couple of the big names who are running it. I've currently got mine from the Selfhosted repository installed, but you've also got Linux servers and Hoshios as well. I believe this one might be the official one. I'm not 100% sure on that. In any case, that's the one we've got installed. So if we just click on that, you'll have the option to install. Go ahead and click install. Once you click install, you'll be faced with the template page. And we have only a couple of different options, so we don't have to change too much. We can sort of just take it easy here. Change the network type to your custom Docker network. As we said many times, that's what we think is the best option. Otherwise, Bridge might be the one for you if that's what you typically use. If you don't know how to create custom Docker networks, we've done a quick video on that already. Other than that, you don't really have to change anything. So you can ignore the 5080 one there. That's one that I just added while I was working on it. I should have actually removed the other one. So you'll only see one for your web UI and set it onto whatever you like. If we click on advanced settings here, we've got the config path. If you have, for some reason, your app data in a different location, make sure you update it there. Otherwise, leave it as is. Once you're ready, go ahead and click apply and wait for the container to start up. Then under the Docker tab, we scroll down, we've got our Requestrr. I've already put it in a Docker folder. If you guys want to know how we set this up, check out our Docker folders video on our channel and you'll be able to set that up as well. We left click and we click on the web UI. Now, when you first start up, you'll be asked to create an account. And we've already got an account, so we're going to sign in. So when you first arrive at the dashboard, you'll notice that it needs some information for our Discord bot in order to function. So if we want to use the Discord functionality, we obviously want to set that up. So we'll have to do that as a separate thing. So let's go ahead and do that now. And just so you're aware, we're going to be following the official installation instructions going from the wiki. So they're pretty easy to follow, so we've decided we're not going to write one up ourselves. So we're just going to use their wiki, so make sure you're following it as well. It's found on the main GitHub page, so just by clicking the link. And then we're going to go to connecting the bot to Discord. So now that we're in the developer portal following step number 3 in the wiki for it, all we have to do is click on new application. So give it a name. I've just called mine YouTube, for example. Click create. Now once you land on this page, copy the application ID that you've got listed here. Back in Requestrr, paste the application ID in this field. Back in the developer portal, head back to the sidebar here and click on bot. Under bot, go ahead and click add bot. It's going to ask you to say yes or no. We'll click yes. There we go. We've just created our first bot. Scroll down and check the marker next to presence intent. The same for server members intent as well. And then click save changes. Now go up to the top again and we're just going to copy this here, which gives us our bot token. So we just copy that to our clipboard. And back in Requestrr, we've just pasted that in the bot token field. Once you've put that in, scroll down. We'll click save changes first. I just like to save stuff first and then we'll click test settings. So give that a second and we get back that it's valid. So that's good. That tested all right. Our bot is working. Once we've tested that the settings work, click the copy invite link button. Now go into your browser, paste the link that we copied and go to it. It'll take you to this screen. It's going to basically ask for you to give permission and pick a server you want to send the bot to. So we're going to click down here and we'll say my own server. Click continue, give it all the permissions it needs and then click authorize. Say I'm a human and it's done. Now back in our Discord, you'll see up in the top right, we've got the bot. It's joined the server like we've asked it to. And now we're pretty much able to do the rest of the setup. So under movies, we then have the settings to configure for what it calls the download client. Now that doesn't necessarily mean it's actually where it downloads. Obviously Overseerr is a requesting app. And so Ombi and Overseerr would be just taking the requests. So you can allow the bot to send directly to your PVR, which is Radarr, or send it to the request apps. So then you've got a log and you can then set quotas on the bot that way as well. So we're going with Overseerr. We've been using Overseerr and we love it. We think it's a great application. If you haven't checked it out, we've done a video on it as well as some other request apps as well. Under API key, copy that from Overseerr settings. In Overseerr, head to settings and then under general, you've got your API key. So you can just unlock it or just copy it directly to your clipboard. Paste the API key in here. Set up your host IP and port, whatever the case might be. In my case, my Overseerr actually runs in the cloud, so I've got a different setup to what it would be locally. But in your case, if it's a local address, use that and the port that you've got it configured at. Then you've got a field called default Overseerr user ID for requests. So that means if it has to fall back on a user, what is the ID that you want to use? So for example, I have a user here in Overseerr that I've just called Requestrr. And you'll see that once you click on the user, it gives you a user ID. So that's the user ID we're then putting into the Requestrr app. So then when we log requests from that user, which is AKA Discord, then we know that we can set quotas to limit the amount that we might want to receive from that channel. It also helps then monitor all their other requests, of course. So once you've put all that in here, go ahead and click the test settings again. Once you get the green light, then you can move on. Now, if you were so inclined and you're very particular about your media files, you can then use the Overseerr category settings. So we can give the category a name, we can pick the instance. So if you have multiple different Radarr servers, for example, you've got your profile, so then you can select what particular profile you might want and any particular lists that you've got or tags. So I've got tags here for this list, for example. Once you've done that, is it a 4K server? Check the mark. If it is, or leave it unchecked. Once you're happy with that, you can then go ahead and click save changes. If you don't need it, then you don't need it. So you can just leave it out completely and click save. Now click on TV shows. Once filling it out in movies, we don't typically have to then change it anywhere else. It will automatically apply the same settings over to here for your Overseerr connection settings. But at the top, you've got a new field here, which is called season restriction. So we can drop that down. You've got force all seasons. So if somebody requests one season of something, won't happen, it will say give us all the seasons. Or you can say force a single season, so you can avoid having too much hammering your systems at once. With that done, guys, if you go to account, for example, you can change some settings there. If we go to settings, if you have a base URL you want to configure, you can do that as well. If you wanted to remove the portal authentication, you can do that too. Then you've got the wiki on the left-hand side. You can donate to the developer, join their Discord, or find them on GitHub. So be sure to check those links out if you really enjoy their work, then buy them a coffee. So we've got the installation done now. We're pretty much finished. So how about we figure out how we actually use it? Now, looking at the permissions of Discord, that's a whole nother discussion. So this assumes that you kind of know your way around Discord permissions and you know how to work it out the way you like. But by default, we should be all ready to go. So first thing we'll do in the channel that you've configured to be able to use the bot in, and by that I mean it has permissions to see and message that channel, we'll go ahead and do a forward slash. Now the first thing you'll see is commands from this bot. Now this is a really cool feature. I think up until a couple months ago, before that, it was a little bit more basic in how it worked. Now it's really, really cool with these slash commands. It's all sort of live and changes as you go. I'll give you an example. So here we go, we'll go request movie. So once we've clicked that, then it asks us for the title. So we'll say Jurassic Park. I'm a big Jurassic Park fan. If anybody else out there loves Jurassic Park, then we've got a drop down that comes up for us. So it'll say, please select the movie from the list below. We click it, find the particular movie that we're interested in. Maybe it's Jurassic. I'm pretty sure we've got them all actually, to be honest. I've never heard of Hitler's Jurassic Monsters before, but it sounds interesting. So we'll just click that. Then we'll generate that, bring it up. Once we're done, click request. If it's successful, then it will change and it's been successfully sent. And that's as easy as that, guys. So now we've got this working bot that lives in our Discord and we can use it to monitor stuff and see how things go. Then if you're using Overseerr, you've got the functionality to integrate Discord so that it sends notifications back. So in our typical, you know, the way I've set it up, for example, for my family is we've got a channel that they can request in, and then there's a channel that's just a feed where it gets updated by Overseerr every time a piece of content is added. And congratulations, you now have a bot that is helping you manage your requests and your media server. I hope you enjoyed that, guys. It was a nice one. I really enjoyed it. I think it's a really cool app and I'm pretty sure most people know about it, but if they don't, they're really missing out. So I hope you guys give it a try at least and see whether it works for you. And let us know what you think in the comments below. We've probably got one more video before Christmas and then we'll be taking some time off like everybody else, I would say. If you like what we're doing, please remember to like and subscribe and feel free to support us on our channel by donating and subscribing to our website or joining our Discord. We really appreciate you. Thank you very much and we'll see you in the next IBRACORP video.